Hello, I am Rahul Ogle and we are going to discuss about our online class. I run this online science class with mainly three objectives. First is that students should start thinking. Second is they should get a good foundation to the subject. And third is exposure in science. Now the first point, thinking is very essential and science will help you to think. Otherwise what happens is many times we learn rule and concept but we never try to think. For example, respiration. So most of the students will say we have lungs, we absorb oxygen, we don't absorb carbon dioxide that we have to throw out. But now my question is this, how will I come to know which is oxygen and which is carbon dioxide? So it doesn't happen that, okay, this is oxygen, so you jump and you breathe that and then there is carbon dioxide. No, don't come, I don't want to breathe. It doesn't happen that way. So the point is this question doesn't come to the mind and that is why thinking is essential. Now this happens all the time. We study earth science, astronomy. In that we study sun rises in the east, sun sets in the west and in the afternoon it is on the top of our head. Now most of the students can answer this, that it is not sun going around us, it is like earth is spinning around its axis. So we just feel that there is sunrise and sunset. Actually it is not moving at all. Now the question is then what about moon? Do we have moon rise? If yes, then which direction? Do we have moon set? Do planets rise? Do planets set? Stars? So the point is start thinking, right? Second is the foundation. Now, this online class we run for Homi Bhabha exam or for a particular exam, but basic reason is that they should get a foundation. So the topics which we learn are like useful for next 2-3 years rather than sticking to one particular CBSE or ICSE or a particular subject and a chapter and a page and paragraph. We try to learn topic wise. Now in physics we study about Newton's laws, we study about heat, light, sound, electricity, we study about magnetism, work, energy, so many things we study. In chemistry we study about chemicals, about metals, non-metals, about acids and base, about reactions, so all these things. Biology we study both animals and plants, their characters, classification, few things about the cell and few other human systems. So this all thing is very useful for next couple of years. Third point is exposure. Now one example, we say doorbell works on electromagnetism. The ting tong doorbell, which is very common, it works on electromagnetism. Now this is not a complete explanation. The reason is that if I want any sound, there must be some impact. So if I take a spoon and hit it on a metal plate or a vessel, then impact will be there or a sound will come. If I just sit with a magnet or a electromagnet, it is not going to produce any sound. So then how to overcome this thing? So the idea is exposure. Show them various things. So here I have got one doorbell, a normal standard doorbell purchased from a hardware shop. So here there is a doorbell, this one. And a small window is cut over here. So you can see what is happening inside. Now here you can see a coil, copper coil. And you can see a rod over here. And once I press the button, the electromagnet will become magnetic and it will pull the rod. And then all of you see what happens. So you'll find that the rod is moving. The rod moves and it hits the metal plate. So here you can locate the metal plate over here. The rod will hit this metal plate and then sound will come. When I release the button, you must have observed there is spring over here. That spring is again going to pull the rod and a second sound will come. So one sound when I press, one sound when I unpress. So the point is exposure. Show various things to them. One more small example here I have got is in chapter light. Now we study there are lenses. Convex lens, we say it is thin at the edges, it is thick at the center. So here I have a lens. Now this lens is thin over here and thick over here, right? And this is also called as simple microscope because it kind of magnifies the image. Now rather than only saying, we can show the thing to them. So here I have a lens. Now you might be able to see one eye big and one eye small. So magnifying effect is very easily visible. So there is convex lens. On the other hand, we have concave lens. So here I have got a concave lens and here you will find it is thick at the edge and thin at the center and it kind of reduces the size of the image, it diminishes. So here I have image due to concave lens. Now you can see one eye small, one eye normal, right? So the point is exposure, right? So basically these 3 points, one is the student should think, second is they should get a good foundation to the subject, and third is of course exposure in science. Homi Bhabha exam can be given in 2 standards, junior level in 6th standard and senior level in 9th standard. However, science can be learned even without exam. It is very enjoyable to learn science. So our online class we run in 2 groups. The junior group is suitable for 5th, 6th and 7th. Senior group is suitable for 8th, 9th and 10th standard students. So if you like science, you are most welcome to join the class. In that case, send a WhatsApp message to us with student's full name, city, area where you stay and the current standard. Whenever the next batch gets started for your appropriate group, we will try to inform you. Now there are many benefits of the online class. One is that you can join from anywhere. Otherwise, the students have to stay near the class and only those students who are able to travel, they only will reach my class or even if I conduct the workshop outside. Now, since the class is online, all the students all over the globe can join us. So if you like science, you are most welcome to join. Second is travel time. So travel time obviously will be saved. Plus parents have to find out time to drop the children, to pick them up from the class. This all thing is like not required at all. So online class is very good in all that aspects. Another thing is that in the physical class, always some disturbance will be there. Some students will speak something, some ambient sound will be there, some disturbance will be there. Whereas in this online class, we do not have to have any class control at all. There is one single button like mute all, and then there is a pin drop silence in the class. So all students are able to hear the discussion and the lecture very clearly. There is no disturbance at all. Whenever I want any input from the student side, like that time I can make them unmute and then they can discuss the things with us. Or even when we are having a lecture and if there is some any urgent question which somebody needs to ask, many times I tell them to raise the blue hand. Blue hand doesn't mean you paint your hand blue and raise it, like the symbol. But with the symbol, I will quickly come to know, and then that student I can unmute and then listen to him and again put him on the mute mode. So this whole thing works very nicely. In the physical class, usually I try to reach around 15 minutes early. That is one reason, is like I get some buffer time so that I will not be late for my class. And second thing is that some students will like enthusiastically, they will run and they will come and some different discussion will happen at that time related to science, but some different thing like. So I thought in the online class also let us try. So I started the meeting 20 minutes early and then I found that 15 people were there in the waiting room. So once the meeting started, I asked them ki tum log itna jaldi kar kya rahe ho? So many of them said ki like, sir, we always come like half an hour early, we start the meeting and then we keep on waiting. So moment you start the class, immediately we are the first one to in, and then we do not miss any discussion. So the point is like whatever things can happen in physical class, they very nicely happen even in online class. Now in the physical class, some students will be on the first bench. Some students have to sit on the last bench. Now here in online class, that problem is not there. Whenever I try to show something, some model or some experiment, all the students are on the first bench only. All of them can see everything very nicely, clearly. So there is no problem at all. So technology is very, very useful. And another thing is that ek bar students ne kuch class attend kiye and if they like science, then they will not like to miss any class. And if there is some family function or some urgent program, so parents want them to take the child with them and then students don't want to miss the class. So fir parents phone karke puchenge ki he or she is not willing to come with us and then usko class mein hi aana hai to kya kar sakte hai. So now there is a very good solution, retelecast. Basically what I try to do is I record the whole lecture at my side and at some other day and time there is a replay of it, retelecast. So if you miss a particular class or if you just want to attend a particular lecture one more time, you are most welcome to do that. So basically technology and this online class offers us lot many benefits and our intention is still exactly same, learn science. And learn science. One lecture of our online class was conducted open to all. And therefore, we have uploaded this video and it is available on YouTube. You can find the link of this in the description of this video. Do go through this class. We would request parents as well as students both to go through this online class. With that, you will come to know the way in which the class is conducted, and you will be able to decide whether it is useful for you to learn science. Apart from this online class, we do many things for the students. I am author of books for Humi Bhabha exam 6th and 9th standard, which are available at various places in the market, also online. We make two types of science kits for the students who like to do experiments at home. One is Do and Discover science kit and one is Electricity kit. I have made few apps which are available on Google Play Store. All of you are most welcome to go through all this on our site oglelearning.com. There we had put few articles useful for students and for parents. There are some articles on science as well as some articles about how to prepare for Humi Bhabha, how to learn science in an effective and better way. All these things will be useful to you. So thanks for watching this video. We hope the information was very useful to you. If you like science, do contact us, do send us a WhatsApp message. Bye bye.